Hello everybody, welcome to lesson 13 of integration. As you know, we are doing chapter 20 and today we are doing the last exercise of chapter 20, that is exercise 20.4, integration of exponential functions. Okay, before I start solving these questions, let me just explain to you a few basic rules on exponential functions. When you have to differentiate e to the power of x, get e to the power of x. The integral of e to the power of x is also e to the power of x. Plus, you need to put the arbitrary constant when you remove the sign of integration. Now, if you are given minus e to the power of minus x, you take the differential of this exponent, the power, and the differential of minus x is minus 1. So, minus and minus will give you plus. Okay? In integration, you take the reciprocal of this differential, which is minus 1, so minus 1 upon 1, and that is how we get minus. In the same way, ax plus b, the differential is of ax is a, okay? So when you are integrating it, you take the reciprocal of this a and 1 upon 1. So we will be applying these rules to solve these questions. So question number 1, I have selected the alternate one, a, c, e, g, and I. You could try the others which are left for you to solve. Okay. So question number 1, part A. We have e to the power of x plus 1. Now you have to integrate this with respect to x. So I write e to the power of x plus 1. Since we are integrating with respect to x, okay. Now I can break this down as sine of integral e to the power of x dx plus sine of integral. Now e to the power of x, e to the power of x plus the integral of dx is x plus the arbitrary constant is vr. Now let's move on to the next one, c. You have 2 e to the power of 3x. Now when you are integrating this, let me write this 2 outside, e to the power of 3x. Integrating it with respect to x. So, we will come back with this. The differential of 3x is 3. You take the reciprocal of that. E to the power of 3x plus the answer. Let's move on to the next one. E to the power of minus 2x. Let's integrate e to the power of minus 2x. X, dx. The differential of minus 2x is minus 2. We take the reciprocal, it's 1 upon 2, e to the power of minus 2x plus. There you go. I hope it's clear to you all. Let's solve the next one. G, e to the power of 2x plus 1. So, integral of e to the power of 2x plus 1 dx. So, the differential of 2x plus 1 is 2 because the differential of constant term is 0. So, 2x will give you 2. We take the reciprocal 1 over 2 e to the power of 2x plus 1 plus 1. There you go. I hope it's clear to you all. Let's move on to the next one. The last part of the sum, R. Question number 1 is R. So that is 1 over 2, e to the power of 3x, plus 2. We are integrating it with respect to x. Take this 1 upon 2 outside, e to the power of 3x plus 2, dx. Now what is the differential of 3x plus 2? The differential of 2 is 0, this will give you 3. We take the reciprocal, 1 upon 2, this will give you 1 over 3, e to the power of 3x plus 2, since we have already integrated, plus c. This will give you 1 over 6. E to the power of 3x plus 2 plus Thank you. I hope it's clear to you all. We'll now move on to the next question, question number 2. Question 2. There are 3 parts of this, B, D, and F. I'll be solving them now. You need to evaluate B, 0, 1, e to the power of 2x, dx. So, the definition of 2x is 2. If there is a total, 1 over 2, e to the power of 2x, we apply the limit 0, 1. No, you are putting the arbitrary constant C because the limits are here. So, 1 over 2, this will give you e to the power of, we replace x with 1 and 0, so 2 under 2, minus e to the power of 2 zeros are 1 over 2, e to the power of 2, minus 8 to the power of 0 will give you 1, so there you are, this is the answer. Let's move on to the next question. B. You have an integral, limits 1, 2, e to the power of 1 minus x, dx. Let's integrate this. The differential of 1 minus x is minus 1. This is the total. E to the power of 1 minus x. So you have minus 1, let's apply the limits 1 and 2. So we are replacing x with 2. So we get e 1 minus 2 minus e 1 minus 1. Minus e to the power of minus 1 minus e to the power of 0. Anything to the power of 0 is 1. So I can write this one minus 1 of e minus 1. So this would give me minus or minus plus 1 plus 1 plus plus minus. There you go. Okay? We multiply with the negative sign to the opposite of that. Minus minus would give you plus, minus plus minus, or is the answer. I hope it's clear to you all. Let's move on to the next one. B, D. And now F. 0, 2, 3, e to the power of x, dx. Okay. The integral of e to the power of x is e to the power of x. 0, you apply the limits, e to the power of, replace x with ln 3, in the same way replace x with 0, so this ln e and e will cancel, you will get 3, minus e to the power of 0 is 1, 3 minus 1 will give you 3, the answer. Okay. We have used exponential and logarithm, the natural log in the previous chapter, so you can go through it and you'd know the rules. Okay, so with this we have completed question number 2. We now move on to question number 3. Question number 3 says here, find y as a function of x. We need to form an equation of x and y. Given that dy by dx, given that dy by dx is equals to 1 minus 3 e to the power of x, and y is equals to 4 when x is equals to 0. Right. So what do we do? We first need to take dx on the other side, so if you divide it with 1 minus 3 e to the power of x dx, integrate both sides, got y. Now, let's integrate this, we need to break this up. So dx minus 3 e to the power of x dx. So y is equals to the integral of dx x minus 3. Integral of e to the power of x is e to the power of x plus c. We have this equation, but we need to replace c. For this, we need to get the value of c. How will we get the value of c? By putting the value of x and y, which is given to you, y is equal to 4 and x is equal to 0. 3 e to the power of 0 plus c. So 4 equals to 0 minus 3, a to the power of 0 is 1, c, bring minus 3 on the other side, 4 plus 3 will give you c, and c is equal to 7. Now, I'll take this c and substitute it in this equation. So my equation will now be y equals to x minus 3 e to the power of x. Instead of c, I'm putting its value to 7 plus 7. Hence, we have got y as a function of x. There are some. Okay? Right. So with this, we have completed question number 3. And I'll now move on to the last question, question number 5. Question number 5. It says here, find y as a function of x, same thing. When dy by dx is equal to e to the power of 2x. And that y is equal to 6 when x is equal to 2 and then 3. That's enough. Right. We move this dx over here, dy is equal to e to the power of 3x, dx. Let's integrate this, this will cancel out. Y is equal to, the differential of 3x is 3, take the reciprocal of 3, 1 over 3, e to the power of 3x plus c. So my equation, now, let's find the value of this arbitrary constant c. For this we need to substitute the value of x and y. Y is equal to 6, equals to 1 over 3. E to the power of 3, x is, so 3 log 3, plus c. Sorry, this is 2x, just want to realize it, so sorry. Explain this. Once again, dy by dx is equal to e to the power of 2x. This is given to you. We took dx over here. So this will become e to the power of 2x dx. Integrate it. The sine of integral will cancel with d. You are left with y is equal to, the differential of 2x is 2. We take the reciprocal of it, 1 upon 2, e to the power of 2x plus c. Now we replace the value of x and y. X is equal to log 3. So 2 times log 3. And y is equal to 6. There you go. This can now be written down as 6 is equal to 1 over 2 e to the power of ln 3 square. Just remember that. If you are wrong, school ln natural log 3 can be written this way. Plus, now this log and e will cancel out. You can take this would be now 1 over 2 and 3 to the power of 2. 3 to the power 2 is 9. So 6 is equals to 9 over 2 plus c. Take this on the other side, 6 minus 9 over 2 plus is equals to c. 2 is your LCM, so 12 minus 9 is equals to c. 12 minus 9 will give you 3, 3 over 2 is equals to c. Hence we got c is equals to 3 over 2. Okay? Now we replace the 3 over 2 over here. So we get y equals to 1 over 2 e to the power 2x plus 3 over 2. Okay. Now this 2 and 2 is common. So 1 over 2 is common. So we have e to the power 2x plus 3 over 2. Hence this is the answer.
I hope it's clear to you all. Okay, you just need some practice, and I've left enough sums for you for practice. This question has got 7 sums in all. So I've solved 1, 2, 3, and 5. So I hope to see you in the next lesson that we'll be doing chapter 21 now, application of integration. Okay. So with this lesson 13, I conclude this chapter of integration. I hope you have understood. And please make sure that you keep practicing. As you all know that math does not demand practice, it commands practice. Okay? Thank you very much, and hope to see you in the next lesson. God bless you all. Stay safe.